Welcome back, students. Today we are going to focus on shift and add method for multiplication of two 16-bit hexadecimal numbers. In previous video tutorial, we have focused on successive addition method, and here now we'll see shift and add method. So required messages we have already taken into dot data. Whatever required numbers, this will be continued. Now we'll first see how this shift and add works. Let's consider again the same numbers, 5 and 3 are the input. So here you must have remember this method of multiplication. Suppose I want to multiply this 123 with 45. So what we used to do, we will take this 5, multiply with all these 3, 2 and 1 digit and write it answer here. Now when you come back to this left side and take this 4 and multiply with this 123, first you will mark this location like this or 0, and then you are going to write the result. Okay, and finally you will add this both the results, intermediate result you will get, and this will give you the final result. This is called as shift and add. So here you are shifting to the left side every time with 1 bit, and addition is intermediate results addition. So whatever you will get, that is your nothing but the final. Now we are using the same method here, only we are having advantage that now our numbers are in binary. So what we'll do, we'll take those numbers into AX and BX register. Suppose we have taken in AX as 3 and in BX as 5. Now if I want to follow the same method, then here I am having the advantage that if I use this bit 1 and multiply to the BX, then I am going to get this BX only, because 1 into this number is giving me the same result. In case of 0, if I take this 0 and multiply with the other number, I am going to get the 0 only. So either I will get BX or I will get 0. That is the only possibility when I will multiply it in binary. So what we will do, we will focus only on any number, that is AX. We'll check it bit. If it is 0, then we will not add anything in our answer variable, but yes, we'll definitely shift it to the left side by 1 bit. As this is of 2 digit, so you need to shift it by 2 times. Here also, whatever the size of your number is, that many times shifting is necessary. First shifting is not being that much effective because the content is everywhere, it is 0. Okay. So AX, BX, will take the numbers into, will identify the bit in 0. How you can identify? You can shift it to the left, you can check the carry. If carry generated, means bit is 1. If carry not generated, then bit is 0. Based on that bit value, you will decide whether to add this BX into answer or not. So temporarily answer can be stored into any register. Now answer variable, in previous case we have used 2 different answer variable, but here we will use only 1 answer variable. Now 16 bit, if I multiply, I want this should be of 32 bit, and so I will require only 1 variable of 32 bit. Okay, so we'll start with the procedure shift and add. So very first we need to accept the messages, that numbers. So I will display the message for that acceptance of a number first, then I will call my accept procedure, accept 16 only, and temporarily I will move that number into my n1 and n2. Okay, so I will move that number into, let's say it is n1, okay, from BX. Similarly, we will accept the second number. So for that message will be this n2 message. Okay, we'll call our accept procedure and then we'll move the number into our n2 variable from BX. Okay, now from this we want our number into AX and BX. So before that, you can XOR the content, means you can make that AX and BX 0. Okay, now we'll take the numbers into appropriate registers. So AX and BX are the two registers we are going to use. to store the number. So suppose I am moving this n1 value into x, so I will write the instruction like this, and for moving the bx value I will write the instruction like this. So n1 and n2 are into proper appropriate registers. We need to set the counter because it will help us in iterating the loop that many number of time. As our input is 16 bit, so we'll set the counter as 16. Again, we'll require one answer variable. So before answer variable, we'll store answer into temporary register, and that should be of 32 bit. So here we'll take that EBP as 32 bit register value, and to store the answer temporarily, we'll declare one answer variable with 32 bit size, and we'll make it 0 at the start like this. Okay, now after that we'll start with our loop. Suppose here I'm giving back one as label name. For that, our answer should be shifted to the left side every time by one. So first shift your answer, then check the content of your ax. If it is 1, then we need to add our bx into base pointer, otherwise repeat the loop. So if it is not generating any carry, so let's take next one label. So in next one, what will happen, we will decrement the counter and repeat the loop. For that, one more instruction is there, that is nothing but loop. So what loop does, it is decrementing the counter by 1 and check it value with 0. If it is not 0, then it will redirect to back one label. Okay, but if carry generated, then we need to add our bx into ebp. So here why we use bx, ebx, because this is of 32 bit, this should be also of 32 bit. Okay, so this is how our addition and that shifting will go on. After this your result is solely present into ebp register. So take your result temporarily into answer variable, and then display the message that your answer is ready. So here we have taken sh message. So here we can first display the message. Okay, then we will call. So before call, our value should be in ax, so it should be now eax because value is of 32 bit. So we'll move our value from answer to this EX, and then we'll call our display. Now here small change in our display is, our display procedure will be of 32 bit because we are displaying this answer variable which is of 32 bit value. So what changes are there in display? Instead of 4 characters, now it will be of 8 characters. So this is where our changes are there, first line, second line, then this is our third line. So with this changes, our display will be there. So let's take input as we have taken in previous case, and just check for the output. Yes, we are getting the same output. Okay, 5 into 3 15. We'll check for other numbers as well whether we are getting output or not. Yes, 20 is the actual output, but we have displayed it in hexadecimal, so 14 is the equivalent answer.